you, Physio, Victor Sports, Inferno Sports, Forex, of course, that lovely beer that you guys are drinking, Villa Capri Motel, Coca-Cola, Amatil, the Brisbane Broncos, Pierce Engineering, EcoSmart Solar, Wind TV, Ian Way Toyota, Civil Mining and Construction, The Morning Bulletin, Diplox Collision and Repair Centre, Almost Anything Web and Graphic Design, EMU Sportswear, Stockland, M Group Tyre and Mechanical, Granger Contracting, HM Group, The Capricorn, The Edge Apartments, All Pro, Diplox, Knight Frank Real Estate, Rod Norson Son, Dr. Glenn Gomez, CFM, The Empire Project, Jeremy Engineering, On-Site Fleet Maintenance, Westco Truck Sales, Central Queensland Quarries, and a big thanks to our media partners, also the Morning Bulletin, the Gladstone Observer, CFM, and Wynn Television. And don't forget, if you're chasing some of the great Capra's merchandise, you can visit the merchandise stall at the gate for all your 2014 Capra's gear. Also, we've got a great raffle happening in the Weber's Retrovision Super Barbecue Raffle, drawn at halftime today's game. First prize is a Weber's barbecue with full accessories valued at over $1,000. And there's guys walking around the grounds that are selling tickets. Let me get back into the second quarter now. Capra's down 4-0. Blake Wallace kicks off down towards the J.M. Kelly scoreboard end of the ground.
Now, Andrew, I've been really harsh on you and told you that we lost the LA viewers, but unfortunately, due to some technical errors, you may get a reprieve. Because, mate, we're back to two. I'm happy about that. So,
well, Dom, seriously, I've known you for a lot of years now, and anything you say is taken with a grain of salt, and actually probably less than that as well.
That's right, with the Broncos on the attack here. Balls come loose again. It is a bit moist out there, I believe.
Might have been a sneaky little hand in there as well.
Sneaky. Mate, your spectacles must be good.
See, but it's good to see. Now, here the Capras, in good field position, right? So, obviously, all they need to do is complete to the kick, and let's try and get a repeat set.
It looks like the former French international Sebastian Martens is on the field. Spent some time down the Broncos. Theron Pearson. Yarrabah Seahawk Jr. taking the ball forward. Hit heavily. Ball. Russell Weber. Good to see him back on the paddock with his knee heavily strapped, but it is great to see him back on the paddock.
Mate, the man gets more strapping than anyone I've seen.
Ian Webster. Another Welsh international. We're full of them. Ball going forward there.
Oh!
Great run. Is he over the line?
Number 18.
Garrett Fields, there he is. Brent Crisp talked him up in the pregame show. Down, tackle there. Ball just down in front. Here we go again. Theron, Packy Pearson, as he's known. Ball out the back to Brent Williams, taking the ball forward. Huey Stanley was lurking up there.
They were.
Ian Webster wearing the one, interesting enough. Him, little kick. Ball taken.
Now that's actually not a bad result.
I'd actually call it a good result, Henry. Yeah. Better than not bad.
Well, I would. I didn't think much of the kick from Webster. But, mate, they've come up with a repeat set, which is just what they need.
Ian Webster out there. Looks like he's calming the troops down. Bit of reversal from last week. He started the game and Baker came on for him. So, be interesting to see how that goes. Wallace, they're onto the big Frenchman, Sebastian Martens. Taking the ball forward. Webster urging the referee to get them clear of the ruck. Goes down the short side of Wallace. Ball forward. Marco, great run. The Filipino, Della Pina. Ball there again. Go on the blind, Webster. Is that Garrett Field again? I believe it is. No, jeez, he's made some good runs.
Very much so.
You've doubled our viewers, Andrew. It looks like you're announcing the sponsors is great. Sam Pearce there, another player who's had a pretty bad run with injuries over the last couple of years. Hopefully he can get through the season. He spent time with the Broncos. Out the back, Wallace. Try.
Great ball from Wallace. Had numbers on the outside of him. Went short.
That's a try to Liam Pickersgill. Fantastic for the young bloke.
How good's that?
It's good to see him getting another crack this week. Liam Pickersgill come through the system here at the Capras of playing 16s, 18s, and it's fantastic to see him out there.
Now, Dominic, you had Liam last year in your 18 squad. Mate, what was some of his strengths?
Andrew, I didn't instill too much in him. He's pretty talented young player last season as well. And just being given the opportunity. I know he has spent some time down at the Broncos, trawling down there with their 20s, and he's been in their system for quite some time. And it's just great to see him on the paddock, get an opportunity as a young 19-year-old kid in this competition in the Intrust Super Cup. It's fantastic for him to get that opportunity. Oh, Blake Wallace taking the kick at goal.
Here's a chance for the Capras to go ahead now.
Yeah, 4-all, 15 minutes remaining in this second quarter. Just quickly, Andrew, the Leagues Club down there, Rockhampton Leagues Club, fantastic establishment, great sponsors, great supporters of this club. Fantastic. Always cold beer. Always. Oh,
and plenty of it.
Yes, that's right.
As you do know. Kick is waved away there. And look, the pre-games, you've got to thank Serena for coming down and giving the Villa Capri Capras under-21s a game. The under-21s ran out winners there. I don't know the score. I knew they won.
Well, it's fantastic. It's a great concept for the Villa Capri under-21s to be getting a game here tonight against the Arena Crocodiles as the Broncos kick the ball off. Ball gone down the middle of the field. That's out on the full. Too far. Ooh. Is it too far?
No, it's bounce. Capras. Now, how often do you see that a team scores and from the kickoff they make a mistake?
I reckon you've been listening to snippets of last week because Justin brought that up repeatedly. The next set of sticks after a try is very important.
Oh, it certainly is.
Here we go. Broncos on the attack. Payar passing the ball there. Penalty.
Oh.
High tot. A high shot there. Yep. If we have another look, penalty there given to the Broncos.
Tell you what, Ian Webster coming on as nine there has certainly probably settled the boys down.
Yeah, it looks like he's settled the boys down. It'd be interesting to see, you know, the halves maybe need to take a little bit more control and try and get the boys forward. As the Broncos on the attack. Wrapped up there by Pickersgill, Webster and Stanley. Broncos still on the attack. Slow play the ball. Dummy half out.
Oh, no. That's a poor read in defence there. And they let Kieran Duffin go through.
Yes, poor read in defence there. I think that was Garrett Field. But once again, a mistake has led to the Broncos receiving the ball down the Capras end. But, mate, good to see Kieran Duffin, former Capras player in the junior system here, playing for the Broncos.
Mate, it certainly is. You know, I've seen him at many a representative trial and play for Capricorn Schoolboys, 11s, 12s. So he's been one of our great players that have come through the representative system here.
And you can certainly tell who he is. He has got a fair crop of hair.
Yeah. Might be another thing with the Samson syndrome. Doesn't want to get his hair cut because it might take away his skills.
Well, that obviously doesn't bother you.
Mate, I lost my hair a long time ago.
Yeah, that's right. Maybe you need to talk to Kieran, see if you can borrow some of his, mate. Kick from in front. This should put the Broncos out to a 10-4 lead. But the Capras just can't continue to make those errors.
No, and I think Butch would have sent a rocket out to the boys just saying that that's just not good enough. You know, they did the hard work to get back into the game, and then all of a sudden, you know, a silly mistake. And that's all it was a very silly mistake.
And yes, here the Capras yet again kicking off with Blake Wallace. Kicking to the opposite side of the field this time. Bulls rolling. Picked up there by fair lump of a lad, the number 16 there for the Broncos.
What's his name?
Brennan McBride it is there. Number 16 taking the ball forward. Then it was taken forward. dummy half.
Oh, no.
He's through. He's away. Ball there onto Greinke. Here's the Welsh Wizard. He's coming across. Reece Williams. Oh, great chase.
Great chase.
They've gone the blind. Oh, he's out.
He stepped the footy out there.
Here we are. The Welsh Wizard. Great tackle there by Reece. Marco Della Pina. Want to be a little bit careful there with that sort of tackle. They've gone down the behind. Once again, Reece Williams from the opposite wing. He's made tackle, made another one.
Mate, how good is he? And apparently, I think half of Rocky Grammar have come down to watch him tonight too, since he's a supervisor
at the school.
Supervisor, yes.
Glad to help you out with your vocabulary
anytime,
Andrew.
Or headmaster, but he's a supervisor at the school.
Mate, but that's a fantastic effort. Effort on effort. I know that Jason Etherington talks about that, and he'd be very happy with Reece's effort there with the Capras on the attack.
That's got to be a penalty.
Well, no.
Oh, poor mistake there. Once again, Capras have put themselves under pressure.
Coming out from their own line.
Exactly.
Once again,
right.
Putting the ball on the ground.
And look, we go back to that break that was made by the number nine for the Broncos. You know, we had one man down left on the ground when the Broncos got up to play, so that the hooker's smart enough, throw the dummy and go straight through. Can't afford to do that in these sorts of games.
Broncos on the attack there with Azuma Adams. They'll have to watch the dummy half. He looks like he's a likely player, Andrew, for the Broncos. Cameron Cullen. Capra's needing to work hard here. Tackle two. Here they are. Garrett Field in at marker. Ball coming forward. I believe that is Greinke there for the Broncos. Out the back. Payar throws the dummy. Well, I do believe if we
scores.
Saw a video, that could have been a little bit of a...
obstruction?
Yeah, it could have been.
Could have been.
But try there. Another former Rockhampton player, Duncan Payar.
Yeah,
who I believe may spend some time in the Interhouse Super Cup with the Capras this season. It is a possibility.
Oh, geez, that'd be good for the Capras.
That would be great for Duncan. It would be a really good
And player. I know Butch is a very strong advocate for the Queensland Cup when it comes to bleeding some of the younger players. He believes it's a lot stronger competition than the 20s.
Yeah, certainly a lot tougher it is. So, Duncan Payar, as we've said before, former Mayors College student. Also played junior rugby league for Rockhampton Brothers as well here. So, but it played in the system here in the 16s and 18s as well for the Capras.
Now he's done it hard too because he's had two knee reconstructions.
I'll run with that. I'll run with your stats.
I'm pretty certain he's had two.
It's good to see the young local products are getting their opportunities. You know, playing here with the Capras 16s, 18s, and moving forward as Payar takes a shot and he's missed that one. With the Broncos now leading 14 points to 4 with about 8 minutes to go just before halftime. So, Andrew, I'm not sure how many viewers we've got tonight. We had a lot of shout-outs last week. I've got one this week. I hope they're still listening or out there viewing, actually.
Well, mate, who's the shout-out for?
Mate, we're what back to 22.
22.
We're back. Andrew, you're back, baby. Hey? You're back.
Mate, they've had to warm up to me.
No, they probably have. maybe that's it. But here they are, the Broncos on the attack. Mate, big shout out to the Central Highlands, mate. I was out there today. All the people came along to me coach course. It's fantastic to have them. I didn't tell them I was on. So if they're watching, thanks for your support.
Mate, that's a great breeding ground for some good footballers out in the Highlands too.
Certainly, mate. And here they are, the Broncos now. Tackle number 3. Balls come free again. I'm not sure if they're playing with a football or if it's a cake of soap.
And here we go. The Capras just need to settle down now. They've got one.
Is that a Q symbol on the football, Andrew, or is that a dove symbol?
Oh,
it could be. Here's Webster.
Webster going from
furring
dummy
through
half.
Again. Unlucky to get a penalty, I believe, there. Ball now out the back to Wallace. Wallace on a Pickersgill. Try scorer early on. Here we are.
Boys
Looks
need
like
to
Webster.
Get some
He's
shape.
Come back towards the post. He's positioned him at the post. The big Frenchman, Sebastian Martins. Webster. Pleading with his players to push up on the footy. Huey Stanley now. Numbers in tackle. The Broncos are getting a lot of numbers in tackles this evening.
The Broncos defence, not leaving any gaps on the try line.
No, none at all. Ball through, Marmon Barber. Can they catch him on the in goal? No, he gets out. Great work by Marmon Barber.
I think that may have been a bit of a poor option there from Wallace. He did have a couple of overlaps over there, or one overlap.
Broncos here now on the attack. Capra's needing to probably finish their sets of six a little bit better. Here we are again. Tackle there by Sam Pierce. Working hard. There he is, dummy half. Cullen kicking out, looking for a 40-20. That's a fair purchase on that ball. And there he is, the Welsh Wizard, picking the ball up. As I've mentioned before, leading try scorer for the Welsh international side. Beats one defender. Capras. Some of the players walking back with about 5 minutes to go before half time. Stanley taking the ball forward.
Oh. Poor communication there.
Ball down by Bobby Nona.
Poor communication between those boys then. Boys coming in for a scrum now. Broncos in a good attacking position. They're about 30 metres out. Another opportunity for the Broncos. Capras need to dig in. They don't want to let the Broncos in there with 5 minutes left to play.
Mate, the Broncos will have to work hard here, Andrew.
Well,
penalty. Another one. High contact.
Well, they've
been let to take the quick tap. Cullen beats one defender. I'm going to check the balls at halftime, Andrew. I believe it's been sponsored by Dove. This has just been a drop-a-thon.
Mate, how slippery is it?
And it might be like book club week, where if you read a book, you get a dollar. Might be if you drop the ball, you get a dollar. Because there's been a drop-a-thon today.
The boys are certainly running out with the old can of super glue to spray onto the hands.
I've never seen super glue in a can, Andrew, but I'll be glad to see that. I'll be checking Bunnings out tomorrow.
Bunnings have a full range of products when it comes to gluing things.
Right, mate. If we keep mentioning them, we're going to have to ask them for some dough because, mate, the Cabras have some great sponsors.
Oh, we'll have to. Yes, they certainly do.
Mate, the Cabras on the attack. Ball played there by Marco Della Pina. Taken forward there. Looks like he's got a fair haircut this week because Gil, I think he was pumped up.
Oh, the ball's coming out the back.
Bobby Nona. We got to play for the first.
Oh, first Gwenaside.
Gwenaside just the other day. And I believe he may have spent a week with Newcastle. Is that right? Ball taken forward. We're in their half with about 3.5 minutes to go. Baker. On to Martins. He's a fair lump of a lad, the big Frenchman. Baker back on the field. Ball out the back onto Wallace. Pierce taking the ball forward. Be looking for a quick play here. Ball on to the right. Stuck in the air. I wasn't sure if that was tackle five, Andrew.
Get on it, get on it, get on it. Go, he's got to go. Yes, Blake he's Wallace. In. Blake Wallace.
And that's a try to Blake Wallace. See it quite often where the ball hits the ground.
Exactly right. He's put the ball up. A bit of miscommunication there. Marmon's jumped for it. Come off the shoulder. Blake Wallace picks it up and goes through. Splits the defence there. Right underneath the black dot there. 4 points.
How many times do we see it, Andrew? With ball on the ground. Mistake made.
And suddenly everyone stops.
Yeah.
Everyone stops.
It was good to see the Sebastian Martins. He may have been a representative for France in tunnel ball. He was quite proficient at that, watching the ball go through his legs.
Hands like feet.
Mate, it just went straight through. He didn't even get his hands there.
Didn't worry about it.
Great sidestep from Blake Wallace. Mate, while I've got the opportunity, I'll throw a shout-out to Richie Duff. It's good to see Richie Duff at the footy. It's great to see him, President of Gladstone Junior Rugby League. It's great to see the big truck here.
Listen, hasn't he done wonders with Gladstone since he's taken over the junior presidentship?
Oh, let's not talk him up too much, mate. His head's big enough as it is. Wallace with a kick from in front. Over we go. 14 points to 12. Is that right, or 14 points to 10? We had 10. My maths has not changed from last week.
Mate, that trip back in from the island certainly fried your head, didn't it?
Certainly, mate. But I believe that wasn't tackle five when Wallace stuck the ball in the air, but a good end result there for that set of six.
A good end result. There was a good chase there from all the Capra boys through there from that kick.
It was good to see them contesting the ball.
Yes.
And I believe we could be going again this time.
Oh, finally.
What did we say, Andrew?
Yes.
The first set of six after
a try has been scored. But, hey, it's a team that had the try scored against them made the mistake this time.
No, that's
not
right.
Not the team that should be in possession.
And, Andrew, oh, here we go with the kick into touch there.
This will be good. The boys will be able to build on this now. They've scored a try. So they're about 30 metres out.
Here we are. Reece Baker in the number two. There's a bit of number swapping going on out there. We had this last week. Last week we had three number ones on the field at one time. Here we go.
Baker. I think Reece was looking for a smaller...
Theron Pearson throws the dummies. Nearly through. He's beaten one. Baker. He's got a mountain of forwards. Sam Pearce, ball on the ground. It opened up, though, Andrew.
Oh, didn't it? Sam was looking at the try line, not the ball.
But once again, mate, we're still talking about the sponsorship of Dove. We might have to have a word to the Queensland Rugby League and see if they can fix that for us. But it looks like that's going to take us into half-time, mate. What's your makeup of the first half?
Oh, look. Probably a bit of a sloppy first half with the amount of drop ball by both sides. Certainly the Capras had their time to build points and to score, but you know due to the lack of ball that they held onto, they couldn't capitalise on their field position. The Broncos certainly made the best of dropped. The drop ball and the quick turnovers. Both of their tries in the second half came from some silly mistakes that the Capras have played. So, yeah, so we're in for a good second half coming up. And at halftime, we've got the halftime show coming up shortly with Walson, and special guest will be the captain of... or the injured captain at the moment for the Capras, Mr. Gavin Hiscox, and he joins us now. Gav, how are you, mate?
Good, mate. Yourself?
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad, mate. What are your thoughts on the first half so far?
I think we've just got to complete our sets. Too much drop ball. We see there that last set, Blakey Wallace put the kick up. I don't think we've been in the air once with the footy, so if we can put more bombs up and put them under pressure.
Yeah, certainly. I think Butch would not be happy with the completion rate that you guys have had in the first half.
Nah, definitely not. Like, it wins games holding the ball, eh? So we definitely got to clean that up. And I think the defence hasn't been too bad, but we just handed the ball over too easy, especially after a try, not letting the ball go out. So, yeah, Butchie will be pretty cranky with that.
Oh, he certainly will be. Now, mate, how's the injury going?
Yeah, it's a bit frustrating at the moment. I was supposed to play this week, but then I tested it out on Tuesday and pulled up a bit secondhand, so I've been working pretty hard on it. Hopefully I'll be right for round one, but if it's not right, I'll probably give it another week.
It's one of those tricky injuries, the groin injury, that if you don't get it right, you know, it can hamper you through the rest of the season.
Yeah. Nah, well, that's it. Like, it's a long season. 26 rounds now, so I definitely want to be there in the back end. So,
now, mate, you certainly had a good season last year and was rewarded with a trip over to the World Cup.
Yeah, it was a good experience over there in the Italian side. Great bunch of blokes, and I'll never forget it. I wish I was back there right now.
Did you get much game time at all?
I only got the trial. I didn't actually get to play in the World Cup. I got to get play against England. We beat them, which was good.
Yeah.
I played the 40 minutes, so I played the second half, and I was there when we, when the full-time siren went off, so it was pretty good memory.
Mate, you boys, the Italian boys, would have celebrated long and hard after that trial win against England.
Yeah, we definitely had a good bonding session that night.
Well, listen, mate, all the best with the recovery for the injury, and hopefully we'll see you next week in round one. And, all the best for the rest of the night.
No worries. Thanks, mate.
Look at that, Wal. Absolutely fantastic, isn't it?
We're on, mate.
Technology.
We're on. Hey.
Mate, it's wonderful what happens. There was two different bikes sitting here before.
Oh, magic. David mate, Blaine, mate. Have you been watching much David Blaine?
I did watch
lately?
A little bit of it the other night.
Oh, he's going good.
So I'm joined here with Wilson Carlos, the operations manager here at the Capras. And, Wal, it's great to see all these kids out on the field at the moment. It's good to see a good crowd here.
It's a good crowd, Drapes. We had a bit of a sprinkle before kickoff, and, you know, I think it probably did affect the crowd, but, you know, it's still a good spread here, and, you know, I can see a lot of people in the grandstand. So, all in all, I'm pretty happy with it, mate.
Yeah, mate, it's fantastic to see him. You know, a good backup from last week, and as you said, it did rain, so it might have scared a few off, but still, mate, happy with this?
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, like, we're building momentum for the season. I don't think the boys have played their best in the first half, you know, as people would have seen on the live stream. It's fairly greasy, but I think if we can hold the ball and use our big forwards, I was particularly impressed with Garrett Field. Oh, he was enormous when he came on. He didn't get a lot of time in the first half, but I think if he can get some more time under his belt, both of the runs that I saw were very damaging.
Yeah, very damaging runs. Probably a couple of errors in defence up in his own end, but, mate, his runs were fantastic. It was awesome to see him out there. But, mate, I got you here, mate. How good is it to see the one of your great supporters of the Rockhampton League side with... the sponsors up the back and also the people down on the deck down there. It's great to see a good crowd there from your
sponsors. Oh, it's great. You know, it's people spilling out the sides, and the Rockhampton Leagues Club's a big part of what we're able to do here. So, it's great. It's, you know, the place is pumping at the moment, and hopefully we can carry that momentum through to the season and win some games, Drapes. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, well, that's it, mate. And another great sponsor is JMK, and... fantastic out there, support. And whilst we're talking about sponsors, mate, an initiative being run by the Capras this season, I believe 100 clubs being run for a sponsorship on opportunity.
Yeah, we had the 100 club function tonight, and there was plenty of businesses that come along, and we basically had about 40 draws for different prizes, player sponsorships, signed Capras jerseys, and the major three prizes were Origin tickets and the front of jersey, getting your business logo on the front of jersey for the away strip, and getting your business logo on the front of jersey for the home strip. And, it was a great function. Sports Scene Super Warehouse, they were the winners of the home jerseys, so you'll see them on the front of the Capras home jerseys
fantastic.
This year. Yep, and Roslyn Bay Resort. Old Roscoe O'Reilly, my old CEO when I was playing here back in the day.
Oh, Roscoe be rapped, mate.
Oh, mate.
Great bloke, Roscoe.
Yeah, he was channeling all the positive energy, and, he pulled it off. Good on you, Roscoe.
And that's fantastic. And, with that opportunity, do you believe that you'll get an away game on TV? I know you're penciled in for an away for a home game. Do you think you'll get an away game?
Oh, Drapes, I'd hope so. I mean, we had the two TV games in a row, and obviously Brent Crisp was what everyone remembers that for. I mean, he stamped himself as a class player on the competition. Unfortunately, he's been injured, so we won't see him till about round 8 or 9 this year, but he's certainly a player that we want to see. But in terms of TV games, it's tough because they don't take all they take the ratings from a Brisbane based mob. You know, they tend to be skewed against us. I think there are a lot of regional people that get on and watch the Capras and support the Capras. But I think we will struggle to get away games unless we really got to be in the top five and be competitive, and that's our goal this year.
Yeah, definitely. The boys have certainly worked hard in the off-season trying to get into the hard work to get there into that top five. And meet Southeast Queensland board, bias. I've never heard that before in any sport.
Oh, it never happens.
No, never.
Nah.
Never ever happens. Southeast Corner, they're always thinking of the bush. They love bush footy down there. Bush footy would be somewhere like Jim Boomba.
Drave, some of your best, mate, and some of your best work tonight, too. I've been listening very intently to you and Laurie performing. I know you're old sparring partners, and, I just want to say a shout-out to Justin Lumens, who'll be at home listening in here, and he might be quaking in his boots a little bit, to tell you the truth, but, Lumo's a big part of it. He doesn't want to get shunted to the sideline duties. He likes being in front of the camera. He did a great job for us at the 100 Club function, and he does a great job for us at, with the Wynn locker room. So just a big shout-out to Lumo. We'll see you next week, mate.
Mate, a big shout-out to JL. He's great to have in commentary. Mate, it's awesome to have him on side, but unfortunately not here tonight. But Andrew Lawrence stepping up, former work colleague of mine. It's great to have him here, mate. And he also is involved with your, is it the Schwartz Excavation? That's the under-18s, or is the Schwartz Excavation
16? Is the under 18. I think Laurie's actually involved with the JMK Capras.
Yeah, the
16. So he's involved as a trainer or a manager there, and you know, he's had an extensive involvement with rugby league over the years, as you know.
Yeah.
And I think he adds a lot to our program.
Yeah, certainly, mate. It's great to have those kind of people involved in the programs. It's good to have him here tonight. And mate, he was here with the Italian Stallion just before. Gav Hiscox. Big shout out to his grandfather out there,
Cyril.
Yeah, Cyril's out there. Hey, Cyril. Mate, Gav said to say hello. The big Italian Stallion.
Cyril loves the live stream, I hear. He loves it.
Yep. Mate, it's great. It's great to have people like Cyril who get the opportunity to see this. This is a fantastic opportunity for them.
Oh, that's what it's all about. I mean, we're trying to improve it every week. This time we've got the scoreboard. I think we'll add additions as we go. We want to try and improve the picture quality, and we're working with Telstra on that. So, Telstra, if there's anyone from Telstra that can help us out there.
Hello. Anyone out there? Yep. Telstra, please. Yep.
Give us a hand, say. But, I mean, this is just the type of thing that we want to add and give to our sponsors, and we want to try and do it with a few away games if we can too, Dominic.
Mate, that'd be a fantastic thing, mate. I don't mind going to Cairns. It's a nice spot, so I'm not dropping any hints on which trip I'd like to go on.
Yeah, Papua New Guinea?
Mate, I'll do that.
Yeah, I'll do that.
As long as you give me a bodyguard, I'm happy to go up there. But, mate, it was good to have the Papua New Guinean side here last week.
It was fantastic, and I mean, they added so much colour, and to put it in with Woorabinda, I think it was one of the best days we've had here at Brown Park, full stop. You know, we've had World Cup games here, and they're a sensation, but definitely having the Woorabinda game versus the Villa Capri under-21s, who got up tonight, actually, over the Serena Crocs, so that was great. It was great. Hang on, I think the game's on, Drapes.
Yeah, it is, mate, so we might have to turn the camera around and get it going. So, mate, you might have to keep with me for a while, because looks like Andrew's eating, and we've got a great run there.
Nah, Laurie's going into a burger.
He's got a
burger halfway down his stride.
And he didn't get that figure-eating lettuce, I'll tell you. So, mate, here we are again. Second hit up there by the big Arlen Packie, taking the ball forward. Baker into dummy half. Out then, darting run, pushing up. Looks, nearly gets through.
He's been very impressive, Baker, from dummy half. I'll just go through this set before I hand over to Laurie. I think Butchie will be looking for a completed set, Drapes. I think it's fair to say.
Yeah, definitely, Wilson. A lot of drop ball in the first half by both sides, but in particular, Capras. And here we go with a kick. And I dare say Butch would be happy with that, being the end of that play. For getting to the kick's one thing, mate. Would have been great if it stayed in the end goal.
Yeah, Wallace has been pretty impressive tonight. I think he's just really steered him around the park. So that was a good try that he got. A bit opportunist, but I might step aside, Drapes, because some other duties to go to, and I'll put Laurie on.
Well, good luck, Wal. Thanks for joining us this evening.
Drapes.
It's always great to have Wilson Carlos, the operations manager for the Capras. So here we are. Broncos on the attack. Good to have you back, Laurie.
Oh, thanks, Dommy.
Mate, just to let you know, since Wal's left, two people. You've walked in, two people have walked out of the stream. Mate, you've got to do some work.
They'll come back.
What is going on?
Hey, listen,
on, Laurie?
We started with zero at one stage, and then we got up to 33.
We got to 33, I know. Mate, looks like we've had a change in refs. This bloke's definitely got a different figure to the first half ref.
Mate, he certainly has.
Yeah, definitely. Mate,
that's Mr. Daniel Griffin who's taken the centre there.
And it was Jason McManus in the first half. And, mate, it's good to see two local blokes get the opportunity in this sort of in this fixture.
Exactly right. Exactly right. This will really test their fitness out.
They look great in the pink, I'll tell you.
Mr. Stephen Hamilton, the NRL referees coordinator, development officer.
Yeah, big shout out to Hammo out there.
Big shout out to Hammo. Man. Hammo has been down here during the fitness season, watching over them as they're they've got a great PT. No, he wasn't. But he's making sure that the PT that the referees have got was doing the right job.
Capra's on the attack. Baker and dummy half. Arlen Packie back on the paddock here in this start of the second half.
We'll get over the halfway line there now. Well,
both Blake Wallace and Darren Pearson doing a lot of talk in the back play, telling their players where they want them to go. Ball out the backs to Wallace. Williams. So it looks a little bit slow at times, but I dare say that's probably come back due to the fact that the boys are looking to hold onto the ball, Andrew.
Oh, I would think so too.
Here we go. Monster Clayton. The man with the hair. Is it Monster or is it Bobby? It's hard to tell. They both got the ponytail kicking. Kick a ponytail while you can. Here we go. Ball onto my man, Gallen. Not as many involvements as in the first half. Ball hits the deck. Broncos ball.
See, that was unrequired. Okay, from your man Gallant. He didn't need to push that pass. It's a very simple amount. The Broncos get an opportunity to work it out from their own 20. Tackle there by Williams and Wallace. A scoot there from the Broncos. Gallen, Clayton and Williams again. Oh, big number 11 there from the Bronx. Taking it up. Oh, and got an offload. Offload. Brandon Lee there in support for the Broncos. A little bit of push and shove there. Boys trying. Oh, great defense there. From who was that? Heavy Dale and Thieran. Oh, good pressure on to the 5'8", who manages to drop the ball. Looks like it could be on. The boys having a little push and shove. A little bit of exception taken there from a heavy tackle. All the boys run over to help each other out there. But we're going to come back to a play the ball. Play the ball on the fifth, it must have been.
Andrew,
Capra's ball on halfway.
Bit of kiss and cuddle going on there.
Yeah.
Heavy Dale heavy taking the ball
takes
forward.
It up straight away.
Might have been looking for another kiss.
Cop this
there.
One.
Here we go. Ball on to Baker. Here he is, Packy. Promoting the ball to my man, Gallen. I'm a big fan of Gallen. Taking the ball forward.
Mate, I can... Yes.
Here we go, Baker.
The viewers would have noticed that by now. Again.
Out the back. Wallace, out the back.
Shows and goes.
He showed and go, but no one was taking it that time. Baker into dummy half again. Out. On to Monster. To Arlen Packie. Who's pushing up on the ball with him? Baker again a dummy half. These play the ball seem to be a little bit slow this evening. It's a bit slower than last week's fixture. Here we go. Ball through.
Oh, Munster, he's in.
Dry.
Oh,
John
great work.
Munster Clayton. Here we go. Have a look at this, Andrew. Talk us through.
Very simple. One Bronco on the ground. Reese Baker gets out from dummy half, straightens up, and Johnny Clayton gets on the inside of the number 11 for the Broncos, Mr. Adams, and runs over the top to score the try. But the thing in that set of six there, the Capras were trying to get at the Broncos' edges. They were going two passes off instead of just doing the one-off. Let's go two passes to try and work them over a little bit. And it came back to lead them to get 4 points.
With the score being 14-all, it's fantastic that the boys strung a couple of sets of six together there where they got past probably tackle three, which was awesome.
Well, exactly right. And that's a good thing about it. And as you said, the boys seem to be probably playing a little bit slower just to make sure that they control the ball.
Now, just to let you know, Andrew, while Blake Wallace is taking this kick, you lost two viewers. Then I stopped talking.
Mate.
And I'm back.
Thank you. No, hang on, hang on.
We picked up, mate, 10 viewers just because I've started. I think it's me.
I think so too, Dom. Because I know, you know, like, you hate having a chat.
Certainly, mate. I can talk underwater, but, mate, with the Catras now taking the lead, 16-14. Kick over there by Wallace.
Now, let's see if the boys can complete this set of six.
It looks like John Clayton's been given a rest after that.
JC, yes.
I think they've been told, don't kick the ball as hard as you did last time. Here he is. I believe this is young Matt Mizzi from Gladstone. Gladstone Valley's player. Good to see the Gladstone continue getting a run. Matt Mizzi, and I do
Garrett
believe...
Fields.
Is no, it'll be Matt Mizzi, mate. Mizzi. Trust me, that's not Garrett.
All righty, eh?
Mate, there's more number swapping
that's
here
exactly
than anything.
That's exactly right.
So
I'm just looking at
go.
That.
Ball now.
See, once
my
again,
man Gallen.
They're going there two passes to try and just get on
the
edge
there. A lot of
tip-on
plays. Here we go.
Which
Guy
is
Williams
great.
Down the
nice
short side.
Work.
Ball to Marco Della Pina. Ball go
back
forward.
Again.
Here's Guy Williams. Going
oh,
forward.
Oh,
nice
forward.
Work. Going forward. Taken down by the Rockhampton product, Kieran Duffin. Ball, play the ball to Reese Baker. Here he is, Matt Mizzi. As I said, Gladstone Valley's player. Here we are. Catra's great opportunity. I think that'll be tackle five. Yes, it is. We'll see how we end this set. Down the blind they go. Packy Pierce.
Or Thieran puts it up in the air. Thieran. Looks like they're all on side out.
Ball taken.
There. Oh, and?
Great take from the Broncos.
Goal.
But great defence there. Great chase from the kick. Fantastic kick there from Theron Pearson.
Mate, that's something that we haven't seen the Capras do in the first half.
Here we go. Let's see who gets an involvement here. Heavy Dale's in there. It's good to see Heavy. I think he's sparked up a bit since a bit of the kiss and cuddling was going on.
I think so.
Great opportunity here for the Capras, attacking the Broncos line. Here we go. That might be Funga. I think that's Funga.
That is too.
Here we go. Arlen Packie taking the ball forward. Looks like
looking
they're aiming to
settler.
Get to the middle of the field. Yep. Reece Baker in there again. Huey Stanley pushing up on the footy. Great to have him in there. Here goes Reece Baker. Ball, Matt Mizzi. Here we go. My man Gallon goes into dummy half. Not sure what's going on. Burrows his way through.
He's
and
in.
I believe that's a try.
That's a try. It's on the white chalk. The chalk dust has come up.
Mate, it didn't look pretty.
No.
But it's 4 points.
Try there. Peter Gallon gets in, goes one way, jumps out to the blind side, ducks down and runs through. He wouldn't have to duck too far because he's not really the tallest bloke in the team.
No, height's not his. It's not one of his big things going on. But, mate, he certainly gets involved in the game. But, mate, that's come from a lot of pressure there where the boys got a back-to-back set of six.
Certainly did. It was interesting watching Pete warm up before the rest of the boys warm up. He was standing there in the change rooms with a skipping rope, sweating up a storm before going out to do the warm-up.
Well, mate,
dedication.
Whatever floats his boat, I'll tell you. But, mate, it's put the Capras in front now, 20 points to 14. It looks like the conversation maybe at halftime. You know, Justin last week was talking about oranges, but unfortunately we know we don't have them anymore at halftime. But it would have been a bit of the chat going on at halftime with Butchie Hetherington there and his support staff, and they probably told the boys we needed to control our sets of six and work hard and stay down their end.
Oh, very much so. He would have been looking at getting the ball in the air instead of along the ground. And twice now. Going to the air has led to two tries to the for the Capras. Okay, so the boys once again will be looking at trying to get to a kick from the kickoff and not making any mistakes. Duncan kicks off again. Caught well by Williams. Williams takes the ball back towards the centre. He's going to be tackled about 25 metres out on the 20-metre line. 20-metre scrum line, that is. Scoot from dummy half there by our ding-a-ling. Reece Williams. So far, so good. Good, strong run there from Peter Gallon. And it looks like the Capra boys are now starting to get a little bit enthusiastic about playing the football. As once again, get the ball to a kick. Good kick there.
So with about 8.5 minutes to go in this quarter, Broncos on the attack. Ball stuck in the air again. Hey, the Capras look like they've been given a fair rocket at halftime. They seem like they've got a bit of a spring in their step.
Well, I think they've got a little bit of confidence now. You know, they've gone to the air twice, and they've established field position, and, you know, they've come away with points each time. So, you know, they'd be fairly happy with that result there. But
they won't be happy with that one.
Oh.
Straight through Theron Pearson.
Duncan Paiau. Oh, he throws the ball.
The no-look pass, and that's a try to Nicarima, I believe. No-look pass from Paiau. Here we go.
Here we go.
Through.
A couple of missed tackles.
Simple one-on-one missed tackle.
Yep.
Ball on a Paiau.
Duncan.
On a Nicarima. Geez, he's got some wheels, young Nicarima.
He has.
After we just said the Capra's working very hard, simple error. Simple one-on-one tackle.
Yep.
Miss. And that's all it takes these days, Andrew.
Oh, exactly. You know, certainly he's fallen off once, and then the second defender's just been caught flat-footed. Through he goes. Chase was good from the Capra boys, and they'd be filthy about that.
Yeah, Andrew, they showed a lot of urgency. Just unfortunately for them, they just couldn't wrap them up there at the end. So the Broncos now, with 7 minutes to go in this quarter, with a kick from near the post, trailing 22 points to 18. And is that Marmon kicking the ball?
Yeah, that's Marmon having a kick this time.
So Marmon, I believe, affiliated with Ipswich just this season, so we may see him up here in the green. Yeah, the green. Former Mackay student.
Mackay State High student.
The Capras boys will not be happy with that, with the effort they put in a little bit there. Just, as we said, one simple one-on-one tackle miss.
Oh, certainly. And they put themselves straight back under pressure now. So, you know, boys are having to kick off down to the Broncos there. Broncos weathered a little bit of storm there in the first 10 minutes of this quarter.
And Ian Webster's back on the field. There, 6 minutes to go. I said it last week and I'm going to say it again, mate. It's great to see Rugby League live. I'm loving it, mate. And it's fantastic that with our 45 viewers out there, if they get the opportunity to come down, mate, you got to get down here. Maybe spend some time at the Rockhampton Leagues Club. Fantastic supporter of the Capras. Mate, with the Broncos there, think tackle two. Play the ball. Both markers simply out of play.
Now, talking to Mr. Webster before the game, I think we're international too. I think his family over in Wales watching.
Webby,
yep. So,
young,
you know,
Webber.
We're not just live around CQ area.
No, mate, I'll tell you
on
now.
On the World Wide Web, international.
Wizard, the Welsh wizard. We've got two of them. Reece
exactly
Williams,
right.
I know his family over there. Cheerio over there. Big hello also to the Webster family over there. Take their boy, one of the Welsh wizards.
He's through. Oh, hold the ball.
That's interesting. Here he is. He's got very quick feet, Delapina. Play the ball there. Blake Wallace into dummy half. Ball now. This is Funga. I'd love to pronounce his last name, but I don't think I'd get it right. We'll go with Funga. Another Gladstone player plays for Valleys Club down there. The Dyads, the Mighty Dyads.
The Capras boys will be needing to complete a set and try and look at getting a repeat set here.
Here we go. With a run there taken forward by young Matt Mizzi. That's
Wallace
through. He's through.
He's the support.
Great left foot step there by Blake Wallace. Capra's on the attack.
Unfortunately, there's no one else pushing up on the open side with him.
Out from the line, ball goes to Theron Pearson. Throws the dummy. Now we're on five. Tackle five. Here we go. Let's see what the Capra's come up with. That's a knock on there, one of the Broncos. Another little bit of kissing in the goal there, Andrew. Did you see
from
that?
From Huey, I did see that.
Yeah,
from
I think
Huey
he blew
Stanley.
Him a kiss.
He certainly did.
But, mate, great run there by Blake Wallace. It was fantastic.
Oh, certainly was.
Footstep.
Brent Williams was the only one there. Not Brent. Guy Williams was the only one there in support.
That's the problem with having too many Williams. Don't worry, there's Brent, Guy, and their cousin Reece from Wales.
And Ian Webster there just before the scrum pack, telling the guys to settle down.
He would have been waving his arms about.
He does that all the time.
And here we are. Oh, Capra's on the attack. Webster, dummy half. Mate, that Blake's offside.
Oh, and he's got the ball down. That's a try.
Took his opportunity. The number 11 there, offside, I believe he would have been anyway.
That's a nice little try there.
To Delapino. Just have a look here. Webster knows what's going on. The 11 of the Broncos, nowhere to be seen. Oh, I'm out. No, man. Try.
No question about it.
Mate, like I said last week, I got it wrong. He is from Philippines. Fantastic, mate. Be interesting to see if Marco puts his name forward. Philippines is actually one of the emerging nations in rugby league at the moment.
Well, it certainly was. They had a game, I think, towards the end of last year.
They certainly did, mate. They played the Latin Heat. So maybe we could get him to play for the Philippines. Another international in the Capra squad.
What are we up to now? Well, we've got
463, I think.
Sebastian.
Yep.
So that's, you class him as an in there. He's French.
Yep. I think some of the boys have played for Great Keppel as well, mate. That's overseas.
Great Keppel? That certainly is.
But, mate, try there. Great work, you know, from the Capras to score the try on the back of Blake Wallace's break.
Now, certainly the Capras have relieved a little bit of pressure from scoring that try. But, obviously, they'll be wanting to complete this next set of six.
So what you're saying, after that great kick there,
Oh,
from Blake
here we go,
Wallace, with 2 minutes, just over 2 minutes remaining here in this third quarter. Blake Wallace puts it over there and takes the score out of 28 points to 20 for the Broncos, for the Capras over the Broncos, the Rockhampton Leagues Club Capras.
Proud sponsors of the Capras.
That's right, mate. Also JMK.
Yes.
Great sponsor of the Capras, great supporter of the Capras. It's fantastic to have them there. And Jeff Murphy, it's fantastic to have him on at the club as chairman. Ball. That's a fair shot. Ball gone back.
That would have hurt.
Yeah, Matt Mizzi's been rocked there a bit. Here's Guy Williams. That's a bit of high contact, I believe that could have been.
I think there is there. Let's see if the Broncos trying to unsettle some of the boys. Here goes your mate.
My man, Gallen. Nearly topping the ball there. So here we are, Webster. Ball out the back to Theron Pearson. On to Heavy Dale. Heavy Dale.
Oh, Heavy Dale. Heavy Dale.
Mate, shades of his former glory there. It's great to see Heavy back in the paddock. You know, former Yeppoon Seagull and North's player. It's great to have him on the paddock once again, seeing him out there. It would have been great to see him get through in full flight. Ball stuck in the air by Theron Pearson. Huey Stanley
good
coming
chase
through. Taken there by Matt Mizzi, I believe. Yes, Matt Mizzi. Ball there, Broncos on the attack. 15 metres out from their line. Bobby Nona back on the field. Bobby Nona there. Here we go. Broncos. Scoot from dummy half. There's going to be a quick play the ball to both markers. Webster's worked hard. He's on his own. Here we are. Broncos come forward. Taken by Guy Williams and also Matt Mizzi. Broncos moving forward.
So far, this has been a good defensive set for the Capras.
Yeah,
they've
I don't want to speak too
well
quickly because last time we talked
well
about there was a massive
we're
break.
We're on the fifth and last, and that was outside, and they'll just dribble it through, give everyone a big breath with, what have we got, 15 seconds left, down to 10. I think the boys won't even bother about packing the scrum here. They'll go to the break, score 28-20 to the Rockhampton Leagues Club CQ Capras.
So, mate, a big shout-out to all our viewers. I think we topped it at 48. 48,
yes,
mate. Awesome. Got to be happy with that.
Very much so. Two-minute break.
We had some technical difficulties early, so we apologise to everyone out there. But thanks to the guys from Stage and Audio. They've put this all together as well as... as well as almost anything. I absolutely had a brain freeze there, Andrew. Almost anything. Hey, that was painful.
That's called getting a lack of oxygen to your brain.
Mate, I've had that for a while. But mate, we do apologise to everyone out there that there was some technical difficulties. But the Stage and Audio boys and
they've done a great job.
Yeah, it's great to have them, mate. It's awesome to have them here. It's fantastic. It's a great opportunity for the sponsors and, you know, the people out there watching the feed.
So, Dominic, your thoughts on the third quarter?
Well, I didn't know my face was on camera, but that's all right. All good. My thoughts, mate, that third quarter, the Capras actually looked a lot better. Looked to really work hard on their possession.
Yeah, and I thought they lifted in their defensive attitude as well. So the boys did very well. Certainly they took their opportunities that came for it when they had the ball and, you know, established some very good field position and so, you know, they capitalized on that. They got the points. They got the points ahead. They came out enthusiastic. They copped a bit of a hiding from Butch in the sheds. But, yeah, the boys have done very well to get back in and to be leading the Brisbane Broncos combined under-20s leftovers side.
Huh. I don't know if they'll be real happy with that. Lucky they're not watching right now. You've called them leftovers. Mind you, leftovers are great the next day.
Well, exactly right. There we go. We've lost the Bronco supporter already by calling them the leftovers. That's
and you
two.
Lost another one. I actually think it's every time you speak, Andrew. But that's all right, mate. It's all right.
Just lost one with you talking.
No, mate. There we go again. What's going on? Come back, baby. Righto. It's great to hear the last quarter of the match. I'd like to thank the fantastic sponsors of the Capras Rockhampton Leagues Club and also JMK. It's awesome to have them on board. And here we go. Broncos kicking off for the start of the fourth quarter. Oh, ball on the ground, picked up by Sam Pearce. First time since we've seen him since the first half, I believe. Webster in there, marshalling his troops.
Mate, Sam enjoyed his pre-season with the Bronx too. He was down there for a couple of weeks.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he was very happy with that. Mate, the Frenchman, Sebastian Martin, taking the ball forward. Ball there, on to Mark Johnston. Great opportunity for young Mark Johnston. Young bloke, only 19 years of age, a lot like Liam Pickersgill. Played under 18s last year, given his opportunity with strong performances in the under 21 Villa Capri Capra side. And there he is, mate, Garrett Field, the wrecking ball, as Chris called out for him earlier in the call. And here he is again, another hit up there for the big Frenchman. Mate,
the Capras are doing really well now to work over the play the ball area.
Here we go, Blake Wallace. Straight down the middle of the field. Fullback takes that easily. Let's see how the chase goes here. Pickersgill up in the line. Is that Marco Della Pina as well as Sam Pearce in that tackle? Marco Della Pina's had another strong game, backing up last week's performance. Tackle there by Ian Webster and Sebastian Martins. Ball taken forward. I believe it's Azuma Adams. Ball free. Oh, great contact from Della Pina. Tackled there by Reese Williams. Blake Wallace working hard in the contact. Ball comes out. Here we are with the Broncos on the attack. Capra's needing to work hard here.
Try and get
numbers in the tackle. Doesn't seem to be as many penalties this half as... Bit of a rough call there.
Bit of exciting stuff. I think we might have an accidental offside here.
I think he's going to say offside.
Yes. Oh, been waved away. So what are we having? We are having
I think what he said when he came in was, mate, geez, your hair looks good.
I think
that's what the touch judge said when he came in. I think your hair looks good.
He wanted to also say, I need my 5 minutes on or 30 seconds on TV.
Well, for young Aaron there on the sideline, there's his 2 minutes of fame. He's there. He's come on and said, g'day, Daniel.
Okay,
it's
the
great
Broncos.
To see you look good.
The Capras have got the feed now through to a knock-on being issued.
Not sure what happened there. Ball from Wallace at the base of the scrum. No one knows how we got the ball, Mr. Carlos, as you asked me in back play. Ball taken forward there by Funga. I'll tell you his last name, but once again, I'll tell you. I do not know how to pronounce it at this stage. Here we go with the Welsh wizard taking the ball forward. He's penalty.
Oh, penalty.
There we go.
Yes. Finally, we've had
penalty
one in the
puller.
Second half.
Here we are. The Welsh wizard is a penalty puller.
Oh, mate, he's done well.
He's just jagged a penalty there. The Welshman.
Good to see the wingers reliable for, you know, a penalty, as well as scoring the odd meat pie.
It's very interesting. It's a very young side out there at the moment for the Capras with... both Pickersgill and Mark Johnston there, and also Sam Pearce only being over 20 himself.
It'll be interesting to see how the depth of the Capras goes throughout the season this year.
Here we go, Webster from dummy half. Ball goes on to Blake Wallace. Sam Pearce going forward. Looking good, Sam Pearce.
Webster urging the blokes to push forward.
Here we go, Pickersgill on the left. Takes the ball forward. Nearly breaks through the tackle. Strong run. Needs a quick play the ball. Great play the ball. Webster out from dummy half. Here we go. Sebastian Martins spinning. Ball on the ground.
Sebastian trying to get an offload. Was there a need for it? No.
Well, not now that he dropped it, Andrew. That's pretty obvious.
The old saying of if you can't get the ball in two hands, then don't worry about passing it.
Oh, yeah, I heard the one about birds and... in the bush. And
was that Lumens?
Yeah, that was Justin's. Yeah. Yes. Big shout out to JL. Loving him. But, another error there. But at least the error's down that end of the field, Andrew.
Yes, the error is. But the pressure is back onto the Capras to make sure that they try and keep the boys down here. Just over 15 minutes left to play in this last quarter. Mate, the crowd's been pretty good here tonight, hasn't it?
Mate, it's fantastic. You know, like the weather today, a bit of rain's about. Didn't look good, but the rain stayed away, and it's certainly helped for the crowd tonight. It makes it a better for them, better for viewing, and, you know, it's great to have them here. It's good to see both sides of the grandstands pretty full. Oh, ball on the ground. Picked up.
Oh, double knock on. Did not need to be passed. Should have just died.
Luckily for young Pickersgill, we still get the ball.
I know.
Talking of Pickersgill. the under-21s, Villa Capri. You know, the great sponsors of the Capras as well.
Yes.
Good program being run there. Also got the Swartz Excavation under-18s and also the JMK Capras under-16s with their fixtures coming up soon in the Cyril Connolly and Mel Meninga Cups.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, both the 16s and 18s have been training very hard leading into this campaign. So
I know one of them trainers has gone missing. Not sure.
Yes, Lionel Harbin has...
Andrew Lionel? Sorry. Righto, Capra's on the attack about a metre out from the line. Webster, penalty. Another penalty. Brent Williams getting a penalty. Webster urging his troops, telling them where to go. Mark Johnston, great opportunity for him, as I said earlier. It's good to see him on the field.
Ooh.
Garrett Field, the human wrecking ball. Brent Crisp told us to watch out for him. Had some damaging runs early. Here we go again.
The boys need to set up again.
Here we go. Sebastian Martins out the back to Blake Wallace. Ball forward to Pickersgill. Out the back. Bit of a rough call there, I believe.
Yeah, I think so too. I think the ball came out backwards.
The one thing I will very say simple. For the Blake and Pink is he's closer than both you and I, Andrew.
Now listen, Dominic, you brought up before about the losing one of the trainers for the under-18s. It's a coach, actually, the head coach, Lionel Harbin. He has accepted a position with the NRL based up at the North Queensland Cowboys with NRL development. So, you know, like he'll be doing the same job you're doing here in the CQ area.
That's right, mate. He just won't look as good as me. The thing about it is, for Lionel, all the best up there. We wish him the best. You know, it's a shame that we're losing great coach here at the Capras, but we wish him all the best, and it's a great opportunity for him there with the NRL. But the Broncos on the attack about 20 metres out from the line. Thought that could have been a knock-on. Here we go. Penalty.
I think that's a little bit of a square-up from a couple of penalties that that the Capras have been given. A bit of a silly penalty to give away, you know, in the opposition half. Well, he eases the pressure off him now.
Yeah, take the pressure down. Who sang it?
Johnny Farnham.
That's
John
right, he did.
John Farnham, not Johnny. See, Johnny and Lionel Richie.
Yeah, I heard getting about back that. Together. Fantastic. Let's not talk about that. Back to the game here, the Broncos on the attack. Capras. Numbers in the tackle there. Tackled there by Pierce and Martins. Heavy contact there from Webster. And Pierce. Broncos still on the attack. Out the back. Out the back again. Out the back again. Here we go. Brent Williams.
Oh,
I can tell you now, he's off. He's gone. It's going to be a try. Under the sticks. Shut the gate.
Oh, how good is that?
I told someone I'd say that today, and I've got to say it. That's a try. Fantastic try to Brent Williams.
T-R-Y. Broncos were looking a bit sharp there. They had a little bit of an overlap. Mate, and Brent Williams came up, took the ball, hit him on the chest, boom, ran 400 metres.
Was the ball thrown by Duncan Payar?
No.
It could have been. He might have been thinking that he was playing for the Capras already. But
No, I don't think it was.
Fantastic try. And as they'd say over in the English Super League, that's a TRI for mine.
That's exactly right. You got too much time on your hand during the week.
With 11 minutes to go here in the final quarter, the Capras are leading now 32 points to 20 with a kick to come. Mate, he took off there. Brent Williams, I know, has worked very hard in the off-season. I know he's worked very hard on his fitness, and he looks very good at the moment out in the paddock, and he's moved out to the centres for this game.
Mate, he certainly grabbed that ball, took it with both hands, and off he went. I mean, all the Capra boys have been putting in a pretty hard pre-season. You know, full credit to the staff of the Capras to get the boys match fit.
With that kick going over there to Blake Wallace, yes, the boys have worked hard. Larry McDonald being brought on this off-season. He's a bit of a hard taskmaster, big Lazar.
He certainly is. I've seen some of the field sessions that the boys do. I'll tell you what, I sweat just having a look at them, the sessions.
You're sweating now.
No, I know.
So, it's a beautiful breeze here with the Capras leading 34 points to 20 with 10 minutes remaining. Okay, here we go. Ball down to Stanley. Matt Mizzi, wearing 18 before. He's lost the number. He's wearing 8.
Must be something with the new jerseys the CQ Capras have got.
Well,
numbers
mate,
disappear.
As we've spoken with Wilson Carlos, the operations manager at halftime, the 100 Club was drawn tonight. And the home jerseys was taken out by the Sports Scene Super Warehouse. And the away's jersey was taken out by the Roslyn Bay Hotel.
Oh, very good.
Great to have some
Roslyn Bay Hotel.
Well, I think that's what it's called.
Yeah. Resort, Roslyn Bay Resort. Oh, how good's that? That's just around the corner from where I am.
Now, lucky
walking distance.
But another a silly error there. We spoke about this a couple of times in the game.
We,
what
do we
say
have,
needs to happen after a try score?
You've always got a complete after
attack.
A score.
Stanley, Pickersgill in there. I know
he's giving a little bit of a.
I think he's going to blow a kiss to Duncan. They did play junior rugby league together, quite a few seasons. Heavy contact there. Matt Mizzi over the top. Broncos on the attack. Here they come. Down here. Pickersgill. Nice contact. Liam Pickersgill.
Well,
Broncos on the attack again. Out the back. They'll go out the back. No. Hit the front runner. Heavy contact there. Baker back on the field.
Oh. Soft penalty.
On tackle
soft
four, I think,
penalty.
Too. I don't know if it's soft, mate. It's just a penalty.
Yeah,
it's not like an ice cream, mate.
Not necessary one.
You don't get different serves. It's just a penalty. Contact. Broncos about a metre out from the line. Baker standing over the top of him. He's only little. He loves getting involved in the contact zones. Heavy contact there. Marco Della Pina coming in. Good contact.
The boys need
He's
to scramble
gone.
Well here. That's a soft
dummy
try
half.
There.
Over. The boys didn't scramble well enough there.
No, they certainly did it.
Need to talk a little bit more, I believe. That try scored there by the Broncos,
Jayden.
Number 14, Jayden.
Is that Barrett?
We're under that.
Berrick. Jayden Berrick.
Yes.
The boys certainly didn't peel well off that last tackle.
In all honesty, the referee just spoke to Sebastian there.
Yes.
Which, he may as well have put it in Braille, because Sebastian's French, and I'm not sure if the referee understands that. So it would have been a very interesting conversation because he was also there with Reese Baker. And Reese, I don't know if Reese is pretty fluent in French. So it would have been a very interesting conversation there. But going back to that play, you know, soft dummy half try, the Capras probably need work a little bit harder.
Yeah, exactly right.
With just over 7 minutes to go, it does bring the Broncos back into this contest now. With a score now 34 points to 24.
Mate, it does, and the youth of this Broncos side certainly could play into their advantage in the next 7 minutes.
And that kick is unsuccessful with just under 7 minutes remaining here. As you can see, 34 points to 24. Capras leading the Brisbane Broncos. Or Canton Leafs Club, Capras 34, Brisbane Broncos 24.
Well,
as we get towards
tries.
The... back end of our telecast of the game, we give a big shout out to everyone out there, the big viewers. We're so happy to have you on. We'd love to see you down here at the game, but it's also very fantastic to have you on board this evening for this live feed. Broncos coming forward now. Contact Garrett Field in there, joined as well there by the number 12. It could be anyone with the number swaps. I believe it's Aaron Hall. Contact again by Aaron Hall. A couple of cameras left behind. Dummy half. We'll go with Berrick, we called him before. And here he is again. The kid who you want to talk to about hair at the end, Andrew.
Oh, mate, I'll let the kid enjoy his hair while he can. Obviously, he'll be bald as a badger by the time he turns 40.
Dummy thrown there. Taken down by Brent Williams. End of their set. Broncos sticking the ball in the air. Here's a bloke I'm a fan of. The
Reece
Welsh try-scoring international.
Oh, nice work. Gets on the outside of his player.
Beats the defender. Bang, here we go. Liam Pickersgill taking the ball forward. Oh, he's pulled
Reece
up a bit short, Reece Williams.
Yes, pulled up a little bit lame there.
Hopefully it's just a cramp. Here we are. Bobby Nona taking the ball forward. Getting his opportunity the other week, playing down for the first Goannas against
mate,
the Newcastle Knights.
Now, the notes say that Bobby's lost about 50 kilos.
That's correct, mate. It's been a fantastic effort from Bobby to lose all the weight. Ball there, out the back. It's hit and spin there.
He'd be starting
Aaron
to run
Hall.
Around the shower to get wet now.
Oh, that is a poor call. Okay, Broncos on the attack. Ball going to the ground. It did look promising for a small moment, but probably pushed the extra pass that shouldn't have been thrown. Tackle there by Brent Williams. Broncos scooting from dummy half. He's a fair lump, this kid. Ball's come forward.
Great tackle
Matt
from
Mizzi there,
Guy
the
Williams.
Ball forward. Great contact over there. and that was Aaron Hall. Great contact from Aaron Hall and Garrett Field in that tackle. Here we are, Baker. On to Bobby Nona. Searching forward. Heavy contact there. Baker into dummy half. Blake Wallace telling him where he wants to get at. Let's see how we go here. Blake out. No. On to Matt Mizzi. Bit stand-up-ish. Probably could have pushed on the ball a little bit harder. Here goes Reece Baker. Push onto the ball. Reece Baker, dummy. Beats one. On the ground he is. Here we go. Play the ball. Go forward, Blake. That's it. Takes them on. On there. Mark Johnston. Ball at the front. Aaron Hall. Ball on the ground. Got a bit excited there. Young Mark Johnston. Probably
probably could have just played short, eh?
Well, I mean, the pass was... It was on. It was, but maybe his players need to push a bit harder. But unfortunately for the Capras, that's a mistake there. With just under 4 minutes remaining with the Capras, the Rockhampton Leeds Club Capras leading 34 points to 24 over the Brisbane Broncos.
It just seems for the last couple of minutes there, the Capras, once they had that try scored on them by the Broncos, have gone into a little bit of a panic mode and tried to push a pass and, you know, instead of just building.
I think it's the opportunity given to a few of the young blokes. They're out there to try and prove a point, Andrew, and, you know, they just probably need to play within themselves and look after themselves. Ball played there by the Broncos. Dummy half. That's Nick Arima there. Play the ball. Here we go. Another scoot from dummy half. Pickersgill, heavy contact. Matt Mizzi over the top. Broncos player Berwick at dummy half. Out he comes. Ball there. Contact again. That's three in a row for Pickersgill. See what happens here now. Broncos attacking the Capras with just under... Just over 3 minutes remaining. Kick through. Huey Stanley taking the ball forward. Here we go. Reece Williams looking to take a hit up off Blake Wallace. Heavy contact on Huey Stanley. Here we go. Reece Williams taking the ball forward.
And
he
nice
looks strong.
Run.
Looks like he's got some pace. And at heavy effort he put in the first half. Here we go. Here's Funga. Funga from Gladstone Valley's. Ball on the ground.
And loses it.
Jason Hetherington will not be happy about that
one. 2.5 minutes left in this game. We've had a ball lost forward there.
Looks like it's fallen away a little bit here, Andrew. I think it might be a little bit humid down there on the ground. I can see that all your hair's been blown off by the wind up here. So there is a little bit of a wind up here. So,
it's just doing enough to keep it cool, the wind up here.
Yeah, that's right, mate. But it's fantastic to have sponsors on board like the Rockhampton Leagues Club, mate. As I said, the ribs, I'm a big fan of theirs and their nice cold frosty beers. And also, mate, it's fantastic to have JMK on board as well. They're great supporters of the Capras. And also
Weber's Retrovision.
Mate, Dougie, donated, big shout out to Dougie.
Yeah, donated a barbecue for the raffle today.
Oh, that's fantastic.
So, over $1,000.
Ball on the ground there, mistake there for the Broncos. With just over a minute and a half to go, I think the Capras here will try and work a set of six. And just for some of the younger players out there at the moment, it just might be a point to show that we can get to tackle five.
Oh, exactly right.
And just to let all our viewers out there know, with just under a minute and a half to go, we will be wrapping up the show at the end. We'll do a little bit of a chat with Wilson Carlos to talk about things that are happening around the place. Talk about games coming up. I know that the Capras' first home game, Andrew, will be on the 8th of March.
Yes, against the Pride.
Northern Pride, that's right.
As the 16s and 18s are playing their second round game against the Pride on that day as well.
Yeah, so mate, it'd be fantastic to see people here. A great day of rugby league with the 16s, 18s and the Capras all playing on that day. So, mate, the JMK Capras under 16s, the Sports Excavation under 18s, and also the Rockhampton Leagues Club Capras. It'll be great to see people come on down. Great run there from Bobby.
Big day.
Big day of footy. Great to be here on the 8th of March here at Brown Park after the Capras play Burley Bears in the first round. Ball in the air. Matt Mizzi taken there. Fifth and last. Just over 30 seconds to go. Reece Baker. What's going to happen? Huey sticks the ball in the air. Huey Stanley. Here he comes. I can hear the footsteps. Here he goes, the fullback attacking, tackle there. Just over 20 seconds to go. I reckon these young Broncos might have a lash here, Andrew, with the points.
Oh, I think they will.
34-24.
Chip and chase.
So thanks to all our viewers out there.
Marmon's looking like he's going to go have a look.
They're going wide. Nick Arima, wide. Here we go. Go, Funga. You're going to have to take off, mate. That's it. Will we get the last play? No.
Nice
that's
time.
It, Andrew. 34 points to 24.
Mate, a very interesting game. very interesting game from the Capras and the Broncos there. Capras holding on, 34 points to 24 in the end. Interesting last period of play.
Yeah, very interesting last period of play, Andrew. But for me, looking for some of the standouts that you thought that went okay for the Capras this evening?
Oh, mate, I think Blake Wallace, when he got onto his kicking game, was outstanding. Peter Gallen certainly had some opportunities as well. Certainly took the ball up nice and hard at times. So, I think Ian Webster, when he came on, certainly settled the boys down. Reece Baker was electrifying out of dummy half. So I think there are a couple of my picks for the game today.
Yeah, mate, definitely the players you mentioned all put in. I thought, a lot of errors at times, but Jason's got a little bit to work on coming into the start of the season. But, I was very impressed with Reece Baker at dummy half. Thought he looked good. Blake Wallace at times when he made a few breaks as well. And then also I was very happy with some of the forwards out there tonight. I was pretty impressed, like with Liam Pickersgill, the young fellow. Didn't get much time on the field, but he did some good things while he was out there.
He certainly did. He certainly did. I think that, Butch will be happy with the second half of the game. Certainly they can take some positives out of that, leading into their first game against the Burleigh Bears next weekend.
Yeah, next weekend, yeah. Triple way down to Burleigh Bears. Always tough. Burleigh Bears have recruited well in the off-season, and it'll be a tough encounter for the Capras, but the boys will be working hard, and I think that Jason's actually got a few headaches on his hands trying to get his team down to 17.
Oh, certainly has. Certainly has.
Well, Andrew, I'd like to thank you for this evening. It's been awesome having you on board.
It's been a pleasure, Dominic,
You. I love it. It's an enjoyable experience. So, guys, Andrew may be back. We've got to have a few interview processes go down over the next couple of days, but I might be able to talk that with Walson Carlos. So, Andrew, thanks a lot for coming along tonight, mate. And
thanks, viewers.
So
thanks, Dominic.
He's out of here. Righto. So, joined now by Walson Carlos, the operations manager here at the Capras. Mate, the board behind us is gone.
It's Gornskis. We take it over for the post-match media conference, so we'll have to work on that, Drapes, but we haven't got it here today, so, yeah.
Yeah, mate, your makeup, we've spoke about the crowd at half-time. It's fantastic to have them, and, we've got about 50 viewers this evening on the...
We had some technical difficulties, and we apologise for that. The stream that we did have set up, the link, it wasn't working at the start, and we got through that, and we got a fairly good viewership. So I think about on the game, I was really impressed with Blake Wallace. I thought he stepped up. There was question marks over his position tonight, and this was a big trial for him, and he really stepped up, particularly his running game, which is his strength. He does have a good kicking game as well. But I think Blake Wallace really stamped his spot on that number seven position. What do you think, Don?
Oh, I think he played very well at times. There's still probably, little bits and pieces. But with it being a trial, a lot of players coming on and off, it does make it a little bit difficult. But, I thought he played quite well. I also thought both the dummy halves played well, both Reece Baker and Ian Webster.
Yeah, well, that's a headache. I mean, Webby's the established hooker, but Baker's been he's been very impressive. He's sort of a Kirk Gidley type player. He reminds me a bit of Jake Granville, who's with the Broncos. He's very quick out of dummy half. He draws players in, and he was very good tonight. Obviously, Webby's got other strengths. He's a very good team player, and he directs the boys around well, and he had the last pass in a couple of trials. So it's a good position for the club to be in.
Yeah, and it's great to see, because Webby's probably got some viewers still there watching.
His family back home.
It's good to have them on board, up there at St. Helens as the boys come past us here, mate. With the great support from the crowd tonight. Happy with
that. Oh, it is, yeah, big crowd. And, I thought, from the other standouts from the game, I think Reece Williams is a great boy. He's an absolutely great boy for the club. I mean, every run he takes, He beats the first man. He beats blokes off the ground. His quick play, the ball's hard to beat. So there's Garrett Field, just a shot of Garrett Field. I thought he was quite impressive tonight. I know he made a couple of mistakes in defence, but he did some bruising defence, and he's a very, very hard man to handle.
Damaging runs, Wilson. He had some very damaging runs. But just on screen there, we got Mark Johnston. It was great for Mark Johnston and Liam Pickersgill. Liam has trialled a couple of times now with the A-grade squad, and Mark Johnston, two young blokes who came through the 18s last season and in the Sports Excavation under-21s and getting their opportunity tonight.
Yeah, and I mean, they stepped up. I mean, I think Mark Johnston, it was just about experience for him, and but I certainly think Liam Pickersgill's knocking on the door. Unfortunately, he's in a position where we have a lot of depth. I mean, Guy Williams is an established player. He's played NRL and he's played over in France, and this year he'll actually break the record of Heath Eggleston for the most games ever for the Capra, so we're excited about that. We hope he does it with a home game. I think he's about 8 or 9 off it, so that's going to be
big shout out to Eggo.
Yeah, Eggo's
crowd favourite here, Eggo.
Yeah,
99 tries he's on.
He finished on. Can you come back for one game,
come back, Eggo?
Yeah,
we'll get you over the line, brother.
We'll get G White back to give you one of those corner kicks. Yeah. No, they were great in the day. I thought Reece Williams was outstanding, and I thought Marco Della Pina it was really good again. And the forwards, there's some standouts there too. Who did you like, Drapes?
Oh, I was very impressed. Arlen Packie, once again, I don't think he got much time on the field tonight because I think there was opportunities given to other players, but I thought he's a hulking man, and he's offloads. I was also impressed with Sam Pearce.
Yep.
I think his opportunity down the Broncos is going to be extremely fruitful for the club, I think.
Well, he's come back with a lot of maturity. All the reports from training are that he was a very quiet bloke. He really only broke it, come off the scene. He had a couple of shoulder injuries. He came into the squad. His physical presence just impressed Butch so much last year that he fast-tracked him into the side, and he had just an outstanding year from then, and that propelled him into the Broncos. He's only 21, we've got to remember. But I think just his physical presence, and now he's starting to mature a bit, and he's starting to lead the side around, and he's talking to the boys at training, and the Broncos gig would have done him a world of good.
Yeah, mate, a fantastic opportunity with the affiliation, and great for the Broncos under-20s mixed side to come up tonight and play this game.
Yeah, well, I think we better wrap it up there, Drapes. Our viewers are dropping alarmingly. We've gone from about 40 to 22, so there mustn't be really
following. It's not Laurie, I think it's you.
Yeah.
Wilson's dobbing himself in. But, mate, thanks for the opportunity once again, Wilder, to call again. Thanks to all the viewers who are still hanging around. We'll be back, here to call Rockhampton Leagues Club Capra's games. Mate, it's a fantastic opportunity. Thanks to Stage and Audio, and also
almost anything. You're all over it.
I'm all over it like a rash, mate. But thanks, viewers. We will see you around. And as Justin Lumens will say, big shout out to him. Stay classy, CQ.
Thanks, boys.